Hello and welcome to a Tabletop Bellhop Cardboard Coat Check. I am Mo Tuzano, the Tabletop Bellhop, your cardboard concierge, helping you make your game nights better by letting you know what you get in the box with this. This is Star Trek Super Skill Pinball, which is the follow-up to Super Skill Pinball 4K'd. This is published by Wizkids, who most people know from their HeroClix games, but they do a lot of other different types of games, including a bunch of licensed games. I am a Trekkie. I have been a Star Trek fan since I was a kid because my parents were Trekkies. We had a Star Trek Enterprise telephone that like did the klaxon red alert sound when it rang. Like I grew up surrounded by Star Trek, still watch Star Trek, big fan of the more modern series as well as the classics. There's very little Trek I have not seen, if any, actually, to be fair. I might have actually seen it all. I'm looking forward to checking this out. Again, this is from Wizkids. This was a birthday gift. No review copy or anything like that here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to cut the shrink on this and show you what you get inside the box. And I don't know much, except I know you get four different boards on here and that the pinball pieces are really cool. It is a roll and write game. That much I know. So without further ado, I'm going to cut the shrink. You don't have to watch me do that. Here you have the box. It's a smaller size box. Kind of see all the sides here. We'll quickly flip it through. Take a quick look at the back. I'm not going to spend a lot of time here because we're going to show you what's inside anyway, but it does show you what the different boards are you get. And we're going to open this up. It's got a nice matte finish. Opened up nicely. Rule book is surprisingly thick. Look at that. That's not thin for what I understand is a pretty simple game. So it does have an overview here and a list of the components. This is showing you how to set up for four players. There's more artwork than text. The text is nice. I like the black text on the white background. That's nice and easy to see. Showing up the anatomy of pins. Interesting. So it's talking about you have the backdrop and then the actual pinball board. Note, again, I haven't played any of the Super Skill pinball games. You're telling you how to roll the dice. You can tilt. Interesting. Moving the ball and so on. Looks like there's almost an example for every paragraph, which is pretty cool to see. Lots of solid graphics in here. Looks like nice teddy titles. Everything looks nice and spaced out. Lots of white space, some Star Trek art in here. Okay, so you're looking at, though, 15 pages of rules. That's a little heavier than I expected for a roll and write. I was expecting a little lighter, and then special rules for each of the boards. Now, that makes sense that the book says thick once I see that. So it's actually showing off what's special on each of these. Going through lower down, I should probably read off what they were. So there's a Star Trek Academy where you go through the Kobayashi Maru. There's Trouble with Tribbles, of course, based on the original series episode, one of the most famous. There is a Lower Decks, which when I first heard about this game, I had never seen Lower Decks, but now I'm a big fan. And there is Borg Attack during the time period where Picard was Locutus of Borg. Wow. Okay. The Borg one, definitely. The Borg one's almost as thick as the core rules, so there's obviously a step up in difficulty for each of these. So it looks like you're going to want to start off Starfleet Academy. Oh, and then high scoreboard. Okay, that's cute. It's cute. And I'm amusing them. I don't know who Jeff is, but GEF got in here and hit the high score. And then there's achievements at the bottom you can check off. Cute. So this is the backdrop. Ooh. Oh, these are sealed. Okay. I'm like, why is it coming out so hard? Sealed pack. So we're going to have to disenshrink this. Okay. Now, oh, they're stuck. They're like, they're static. So there we have the backdrop. And what it is there's four copies for four players. So one of, oh, okay. That makes sense. There's two. So there's the Trouble for Tribbles backdrop and the backdrop for Starfleet Academy. These are nice. They're obviously the dry erase boards. So no sheets of paper. It's a roll and write using dry erase. Then we have the actual board, which, man, that's busy. Very busy board for Starfleet Academy. And on the other side should be Trouble with Tribbles, which, again, makes sense. Fascinating. Now, before these, then we're going to have the Lower Decks on one side. Promotion. Cute. So if you've seen the series, I don't want to be promoted too much. And Borg Attack, which is kind of ridiculous top board. So these again are the backsplashes, the top part, and then we should have down here the actual pinball machine. Which, man, that's a crazy looking pinball machine. There's it's two sided. There's paddles at both ends, so that's interesting. Again, it says promotion on the side, and I'm just gonna flip this to get the board. So this looks more like a normal pinball. Again, flippers at the bottom, so on. Some really cool art, little cutest staring at you there. Other components, great if you have humidity issues where you happen to play your games. Keep that in the box, otherwise toss it. We got some dry erase markers. Look pretty standard board game dry erase markers. I've seen this brand many times. This should reseal somewhere. Here we go. We're going to do a quick little scribble here. And, you know, mark off this star base. And over here. And, I don't know, circle that. Now we'll erase them. Yep, comes off nice, easy. Nice and clean. Looks good. Then we get to some dice. These, of course, don't have to go back in the package like this. Dice, they look like dice. Oh, they're sparkly. Sparkly dice. Don't want to come out. Sparkly D6 dice. I like them, actually. Like they got a little star field thing going on. Fitting of the theme. Hey, I rolled a 10 or a 6 and a 4. Then we get to what I still think are some really cool components. I've seen these people stream with these, so. Oh, wow. Okay. That's, like, it looks... It's a flat bottom. So what this is half a pinball. Okay, you can't see that at all. So let's pick this up. We'll flip it to this side. So yes, this shows where your ball is. You're going to move your ball around. And if you look, it's like a silver. But it's only half a ball, so it doesn't roll. Man, that looks cool. These boards are so busy, it kind of gets lost on the on the stream here. Here, is one of these a little simpler looking? It's the triple board? No, not really. None of these are really any quicker. So you're like, oh, the ball's over here, and then it comes down, and it's over here, and now it's over here, so on. So yeah, kind of looks like a real pinball ball. Looks like you can have multi-ball, because there's 8 of them in here. The inside, I don't know why. I find that super fascinating. That's it. That is everything you get with Star Trek Super Skill Pinball. There you go. What you get in the box for Star Trek Super Skill Pinball from Wizkids, the second Super Skill Pinball game, follow-up to Super Skill Pinball 4Cade, obviously with a Star Trek theme. 4 different boards for 4 players, total of 16 boards, I guess, yes. 8 two-sided boards, really. And then there's the tops and bottoms. So there's like the scoring backsplash and then the game itself. Plastic pinballs. I was wondering if they're metal. They're plastic. They're actually pretty light. Dry erase markers, rule book, surprisingly thick rule book. And it looks great. I'm looking forward to checking this one out. Now, when I do play Star Trek Super Skill Pinball, I will be sharing pictures of my plays, I'm sure, on social media, where you can find me everywhere as Tabletop Bellhop, one word. We'll be talking about the game on the Tabletop Bellhop Gaming Podcast, which you can find on your podcatcher of choice. And eventually, I'll be doing up a written review over on the blog at tabletopbellhop.com. I invite you to check out all of that. In the meantime, live long and prosper.